Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Grace for Today. It's Monday morning. It's the bank holiday. Hope you're enjoying a day to relax and rest. And we want to encourage you this morning that Jesus has overcome the world. You know, this has been the most unusual year probably for all of us. And there's been so many things crowding in on us, so many things that could distract us and so many things that can get our attention off the Lord. And yet in this world where there's been trouble, there's been confusion, there's been just so much going on, do you know what? Jesus has overcome it. So I want to read from this passage in John. It says, "I have said these things to you that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation, but take heart. I have overcome the world." And that's in John 16, verse 33. Now, do you ever find yourself looking for the easy life? You know, do you convince yourself that what life would be easier in someone else's shoes? You know, the fact is, Jesus, he never promised us an easy life. In fact, he did warn us that, you know, there would be times where we have trouble. But if we look at these verses in John 16, he took great lengths to prepare his disciples for the days ahead. You know, he knew the hardship that would come, and he didn't want them to be caught off guard and feel overwhelmed by what would unfold. Instead, he wanted to reassure them that nothing takes God by surprise, and rather than reacting in panic and fear, they can experience peace right in the middle of a storm. So what is this peace that Jesus promises to us? It's not a worldly peace of comfort or an emotional high. This peace is a rest, and it's born out of confidence and trust in the Lord's work. When Jesus gives his disciples this advance warning about the future trials, he does this for their benefit. He's enlightening them to the fact that God has a greater plan, and he's calling them to hold fast to the promises in the word, just like we see how the heroes of faith are commended in Hebrews 11. When they stand firm in the face of trial, you know, they continue forward in faith. Today, you and me, we can walk with an inner peace despite what's going on in our external world. We can have strength and courage today because we know that Jesus has overcome the system of this world and the schemes of the enemy. The joy that we hold on to comes from knowing that Jesus has the ultimate victory and nothing in this world can undo his work. Notice that he says, "In me, you may have peace." It is a possibility. It is something we can choose, but we will only receive it through him. We're required to stay connected to the vine. We need to remain in Christ. This peace is conditioned on our ability to keep our eyes fixed on Jesus and to remain in his love. Then we're going to find this assurance and we're going to find rest. You know, Jesus speaks forth what he is going to do as if it's already happened. Before he makes his way to the cross and pours out his life, he sees the work as complete. It's because of this that he exhorts us to take heart, or to be of good cheer, as some other translations write. You see, we find victory through our conflicts and struggles through Jesus's ultimate victory over sin and death. So today, I know for myself, I want to remind myself that he has put this overcoming spirit into all of our weakness. He has filled us with his victorious life. It's him that's within us. We have his strength to overcome and his authority over the powers of darkness. Even though there may be times when we feel like the wind is howling all around us and it's bending our branches by its force, we've got to remember that we are firmly planted and that our roots are anchored in the soil of his love. As we stay connected to the vine, as Jesus explained to his disciples, we'll see that we have an unshakable hope and a confidence for the future. No matter what battles lie ahead, we can walk towards them knowing that he is faithful and we will be more than conquerors in Christ. That is so encouraging, isn't it? To hear that, to remember that even though there's going to be trouble around us, you know, we can't be walk through this world without experiencing trouble, but we can take heart. Jesus has overcome it all, and his resurrection power is on the inside of us. We don't need to shrink back and be afraid. We can just rest in who he is and what he's done for us. So Jesus, we want to thank you for that this morning. We want to remind ourselves, if we have sickness in our body today, we want to come to you, Jesus, and recognize that your body was broken so that we could be healed and whole today. There is no sickness in your body, Jesus. You are perfect and complete. And as you are, so are we in this world. So we thank you, Jesus, for your body broken for us, that we can receive your wholeness. And we thank you for your blood, shed for us, for the forgiveness of our sins, that nothing separates us today from receiving from you, Lord, that we're worthy, not because of what we've done, but because of everything that you've done for us. So thank you, Lord. So I hope you enjoy the rest of your day, get time to relax, and just to remember, rest in his presence today. As you hopefully have got a break from work, just allow his love to wash over you. Fix your eyes on him and know that no matter what is coming in your week, no matter what you might be facing, he has conquered it all and his spirit lives within you. Have a brilliant day.